A smaller hall is dedicated to 18 dragon lords, but it contains only spirit tablets inscribed with names. Where are the effigies? You're watching China's historic towns, Xinjiang, a town with military roots. Visitors to the old town of Xinjiang in Gansu Province are usually struck by its exceptionally well-preserved citadel, once known as the Citadel of Tao Zhou. However, its most outstanding landmark is a temple dedicated to the town god. Dragon lords were worshipped here, and according to local tradition, there's a relationship between them and the ancient citadel. Just before 2012's Dragon Boat Festival, the crew sets out to the town to find out the truth about these dragon lords.
这样的一个小镇子上，为什么要供奉这么多位的龙神呢？嗯，你猜做红楼二年，也就是公元1319年8月，朱元璋为孔国交塞，嗯，下次交开国功臣都纷纷为神，哦，赤米贼，嗯，江宁府东北的紫米山设立功臣庙，并在全国各地立庙，祭祀。 四者修孝四子，僧者属于日弟子，嗯，嗯，叫苏达、邵如春、刘文尊这些人，嗯，奉奉为神，这些牌位供奉的，就是他们这些人。
这个死者肖像四肢嘛，对吧？那么为什么我看到这里的只有牌位，而没有肖像呢？
这是都有肖像，这些神，因为他每年的只有三天时间放在这里。
哦，
三天过了之后，他们都会得到他们的各自的那个庙里去了。
各自还有各自的那个，
各自的庙呢啊。
那就下面写的这个水墨川呀、燕家堡，就是他们各自的
地方。
赵馆长，这是谁的神像？
这就是那黄庙龙神殿里面供奉的，上奉南郊众多三边行持大龙王李贵的塑像。 这就是当年金氏将军木易日文族的麾下的小兵，他在明年的这个大部分时间就供奉在这里，到了冬春了之。
刘老先生现在家里有几口人呢？我家里有五口人。五口啊，五口人。这个老婆。哦。这个儿子。哦。这个孙子，还有个儿媳。哦，还有儿媳妇。原来祖籍是哪里的？
我是原先住址是六安县。
六安县。哦，对对对。那现在来这个地方居住了多长时间？
六百多年了。
The
picture hung in the Liu family's living room is a picture of the ancestral god mentioned by Liu Fuyuan.
六百多年，那看上去怎么还这么新？这是十二年又重发了噻，把旧的封神过，新的又挂上。哦。这就是我们的家谱。嗯。这是，它里面有朱元璋的三头赤峰圣旨。
圣旨啊。
啊，圣旨。
圣旨有三道。
那又把它冬天取回来呢，因为它有春天的话，它有过雨日丰。 佛丘入峰，卧谷峰等，哎，这本身是他这个家，他这个卧谷城头，为啥叫卧谷城头？就是他这个住宿的地方。
Has over 23,000 residents. Most of them are Han people. Historical records say that the ancestors of these people came from a rich and populous region between the Yangtze and Huai rivers. After more than 600 years, how do these descendants remember their ancestors and the culture they brought with them from their ancestral home? How does this ancestral inheritance influence the lives of these people today? It's market day, and all of a sudden the town is busier and more crowded than usual.
你们好，大姐，你们这是干什么去啊？赶集去。赶营啊？从哪里来的呢？杨义乡。杨义乡。哦，你去赶营做什么呢？
买镰刀。买镰刀啊？就是买点这个自家用的一些东西是吧？好，好，好，那你们祝你们买。
People who live here say the market dates back to the time when the troops of the Ming dynasty cultivated the wastelands that used to be here and started to grow grain. The local people would barter with the garrison troops. A market is still held here every 10 days. Gan'an Tibetan Autonomous Prefecture. It's mostly surrounded by grasslands with forests in the upland areas, inhabited for the most part by Tibetans, Hui people and other ethnic groups. But most Xincheng residents are Han people. The way local women are dressed draws the crew's attention in today's market. Both the clothes and the silver jewelry and ornaments they wear seem different from those worn by the Tibetan and Huai women living nearby. They are also different from styles adopted by rural Han villagers in the nearby areas. Could it have anything to do with that remote region between the Yangtze and Huai rivers?
<音><音>
Most of the inhabitants living in downtown Xincheng are the descendants of the Ming troops who were garrisoned here. Two town officials introduced the crew to Li Tiancheng. Despite the passage of time, the people of Xincheng continue to pass on the traditions of their Ming Dynasty ancestors down the generations. In their minds at least, the renowned general Li Wenzhong really is both a man and a god. General Li Wenzhong is revered in Xincheng. Why then is his statue headless? How do the descendants of these Ming troops honor their ancestors? China's historic towns, Xincheng, a town with military roots, continues now. Now the crew arrives at Duanyanggou village to the north of Xincheng town in search of General Li Wenzhong's host temple. The villagers here are preparing for the annual procession of the effigies of the spirits. Because of his reputation, you might think an effigy of Li Wenzhong would be something awe-inspiring, perhaps showing him astride a huge war horse, mighty sword in hand.
做的时候，这个六这个拄着猴子，梦见这个新来的要到他的轿山呢。
嗯。
他一下子是什么？这就是他的胃是个心了。哦，他是骨骨给他，骨骨给撞了的。嗯，走。他一下子就晓得在什么地方去。嗯，在他的头颈，在睡梦。
Squeeze here, so it's not easy to find an opportunity to charge ahead. When the effigies of the Dragon Lords reach the town's eastern gate, a simple ceremony is held. It's only then that the race officially gets underway. In the past, the runners ran wherever they liked, and people would even try to obstruct them. Sometimes there were even violent clashes. It is believed that whoever's effigy was fastest would win respect, good fortune, and a plentiful harvest. On this occasion, it's hard to see which Dragon Lord is going to take the lead and win first place. The founding emperor of the Ming Dynasty, which lasted from 1368 to 1644, Zhu Yuanzhong, ordered people to build temples and start processions such as these all over the country. In other places in China, these practices have largely vanished. But over 600 years later, the tradition continues to be passed down from generation to generation in Xincheng. The descendants of the Ming troops who came here continue to honor and commemorate their ancestors and the culture they brought with them.